If you have ever read the Holy Quran, which I certainly hope you have, then you must have seen these separated letters at the beginning of some surahs. In fact, the second surah, Surah Al-Baqarah, starts with them too, so you can't really miss them. It has always been a point of discussion about what these letters actually mean. Why are they only there at the beginning of surahs? And how can we recite them properly? And this video tutorial will try and answer all these questions. So let's get started. First, it is important to mention that there are many different viewpoints regarding these letters. In Arabic, we call them al-huruf al-muqata'ah. And I chose to show three of the main stances of scholars and researchers. So the first group said that the Prophet, peace be upon him, has never interpreted these separated letters for us. So they would refrain from trying to interpret them, and they would say that the ultimate wisdom and secret of these letters and their meaning is part of the unknown or ghaib, which is a very fair point to make, of course. But then there is the second group, and this group thinks that there are many secrets buried inside these letters and we can't find out about them. So they went on trying to do just that. So some tried to turn these letters into words to make meaningful sentences, and they came up with different outcomes. Like, they came up with this sentence, نَصٌ حَكِيمٌ قَاطِعٌ لَهُ سِرٌ, which translates to a wise text that has a secret. And others came up with a different sentence, صِرَاطٌ عَلَى حَقٍ نَمْسِكُهُ, which translates to we hold onto a right path. And others tried to turn each letter into a corresponding number, and then tried to add these numbers together to reach to a certain ratio or a golden number. The point is, those who belong to this school of thinking have come up with so many attempts to explain the nature and the meaning behind these letters. But none of them provided any evidence for these interpretations, however. Then there is the third group. And this group tried to discover the wisdom of these huruf, muqatta'ah, using the narrated interpretations of the Sahaba. The Sahaba are the companions of the Prophet, peace be upon him. And the scholars in this group came up with one interpretation, which says that these letters are there to show us the miraculous nature of the Holy Quran, which implies that even though the Quran is composed of these simple letters that we use in our daily speech, like Alif Lam Mim, all of mankind is still unable to match it and produce not even one surah or ayah like it. This was particularly the ultimate challenge for Arabs at the time of the revelation of the Quran, since they were very known for their poetic and literary skills. And the supporters of this viewpoint provided some evidence to support this claim. First, they said that when reciting the Holy Quran, these letters have to be recited like Arabic alphabet. So you don't actually pronounce it as a word, but you actually have to spell it as if you're teaching someone how to spell the Arabic alphabet. Alif Lam Mim. This concept, as if you are teaching someone the alphabet, is in accordance with the Quran being challenging for non-believers into mimicking the Quran and mocking them for not being able to do that, although it is made up using the simple letters of Arabic alphabet that everyone has access to. Second, wherever these separated letters are mentioned in the Holy Quran, they are followed by the mention of the book, which means the Holy Quran. This makes a connection between these letters and the mention of the Holy Quran and its challenge to those who do not believe in it, as miraculous and wise as it is. Let's have a look at some examples to understand the point even further. In the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah, we see Alif Lam Mim. ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. And another example in Surah Yunus. Alif Lam Ra. Tilka ayatul kitabil hakim. And there are so many examples of the same nature which all share the same pattern. For these reasons and many others, this view was supported by many scholars. And personally, I go with this stance because it is supported by some evidence. But it is very important to mention that Allah knows best. And He is the only one who knows the ultimate wisdom and the meaning behind these letters. Now that we know what حروف مقطع at the beginning of surahs probably mean, let's see how we can recite them properly when it comes to the Tajweed rules. The separated letters are divided into three sections. First, letters that will get full med, which is six harakat. These letters are Lam, Mim, Noon, Sin, Sad, Qaf, Kaf, and Ain. Notice how I pronounce these letters. You will notice that these letters, if you want to spell them, you will have to spell them in three letters. So Lam, you're going to write it like that. Mim will be written like that. And each time you recite these letters separately, you will have to give them six harakat. And if you want to know more about what harakat means and how long they are, please check this video for more information about med and how you can deal with it. The second group of letters will only get natural med. Natural med means only two harakat, which is about 1 second. These letters are ha, ya, ra, ha, ta. Notice how I pronounce these letters as well, and you will see that each of these letters is made up only of two letters. So we say ha, we don't say ha. We say ya, we do not say ya. We say ra, we don't say ra. And these letters, like I said, they get natural med. Finally, the last group, which is made up of just one letter, which will not get any med, which is the letter alif. So let's try and apply this knowledge on the beginning of Surat Maryam. Surat Maryam starts with five separated letters. Let's see how this sounds when it is recited.
كاف ها يا عين صاد.
Notice how quickly I went from ha and ya, because both of them are only getting natural med. The rest of these letters got six harakat. Another example.
Hamim.
Now that you get the concept of the recitation of these separated letters, there are two things that you have to take into consideration. First, when reciting these letters, you apply all Tajweed rules when you move from one letter to another. Because when you look deeper into these letters, they are basically words, since you pronounce them as such. So when you say lam and then you follow it up with mim, you will see that lam ends with the letter mim and the mim starts with the letter mim. So this means that they will have to be fused together into one mim. So you will say
alif lam mim.
Another example, when going from the noon at the end of sin and the qaf, they will have to be ikhfa, and it should sound like that.
Ayn-sin-qaf.
But pay attention, because you do not merge between the separated letters and whatever words that come after them. So in Surat Al-Qalam, for example, you will not merge between noon at the end of the word noon and the waw that comes afterwards. So there is no idgham. You will have to keep them separated in case you want to keep on reading, and it will be pronounced as such.
Noon wal-qalami wa ma yasturun.
And if you want to learn more about what idgham, ikhfa, iqlab, and these kind of concepts are, make sure you check out this video, and I'll leave its link in the description as well. So, in a nutshell, we might not know exactly what these separated letters actually mean, but we do know exactly how the Prophet, peace be upon him, recited them. And that is, when reciting these letters, you give them 6 harakat, which is about 3 seconds. And when reciting these letters, you give them only 2 harakat. And the alif does not get any. And remember to apply the Tajweed rules when you move from one letter to another, but you will keep the letters separated from whatever words that come afterwards. Finally, the ultimate wisdom behind separated letters is of Allah's knowledge. There are so many attempts to interpret them, but as anything in Islam, only follow evidence. Thanks for watching. I hope you've learned something new today. If you did, please like and share the video for other people to learn from it. And please subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.